Hi, this is Malik. I'm making a video tutorial explaining how to make a character select screen for your Open Beats of Rage mod. This video tutorial is mainly for the users on the www.chronocrash.com forum, where we make our Open Beats of Rage games. So the main point of this tutorial is to get a flashing box around the character you're choosing to select. It's a bit of a tricky process, but it can be easily done. I'm just explaining how to do it to avoid any further confusion on people who want to use this trick. So this is my character select screen, and I've saved it in my mods folder under data, BGS for short for backgrounds, and then select.png. You can do it as select.gif, it doesn't really make a difference. But this is the template, so this has got all my selectable heroes in the background, and everything is one plain background sheet. And what we want to do is put a box animation above each of these squares. Let me just show you one of these box animations. Now, these are the boxes used for Brian Fury, for player 1, player 2, and player 3. Now, the way this works is the size of my mod is 480 times 272. So that's the size of this character select screen. But with the templates, you want to make a box 480x1. It has to be an extra pixel just for this to work. I'm not sure why, it's just maybe a bug or something. So 480x1, and then the height, depending on how many players you want, you would times it by that many. So obviously in my mod I've got 3 players. So the height of my mod is 272, times that by 3, 816. So as you can see with my boxes, the size is 481 times 816. So I made this special template to help me make these boxes so they're in the correct place. And I'll just zoom right in to show there is a single grey line at the start of it. This is just that extra pixel, so the boxes are past the first pixel. So you make a simple line, any colour, single pixel in width. After that, this is my entire select screen right here. And then directly under it, without any gaps, I've done another select screen. I've inverted the colours so you can tell where the first select screen and the second select screen start and end. And also I've done a third one at the bottom. Obviously if you're going to have 4 players in your mod, you need a fourth box at the bottom. Now the way I've got the boxes in the correct position is by adding multiple layers above these. So this is a layer I've just unhidden. It was hidden before. Now I've unhidden it, you can see I've already drawn the box around Kazuya's face. And obviously you can have any kind of box. You could even have a single 1P, 2P or 3P, 4P sign showing which character you're waiting to select. And on this box down here, as you can see, this purple bit's been moved to the middle. If I unhide another layer, you should be able to see the text. Yep, there you go, the text player 2, top one is player 1, and the bottom one is player 3. So as you can see on player 3, this is in a different place. These could potentially overlap each other. So you need the player 1 text, the player 2 text, and the player 3 text to be in different places for the same character. Okay, so I mean that's quite simple enough. But once you've got that done, I'll just show you what you need to modify on levels TXT. Menu placement is what you need to modify. So there's P1S menu. These are the recommended settings, you can use your own if you wish. So I've done -1. This is very important. If you put that to 0, it will display nothing. I'm not sure why. But you have to set it as -1 for player 1, player 2 and player 3, and obviously if you've got a fourth player you can add them. And then this is the height, so the first one is starting right up here at 0. So this entire screen here will be displayed, or anything within this screen. So that will be this first screen here. So obviously let's just actually show it. So if I copy that, paste as new selection. Now Let me just drag this down so the whole screen is going to be covered, and that box will perfectly cover Brian Fury's face. As you can see, it's in the right place. There. Just tap it a little bit, alright? Now, if I delete it, you'll see Brian Fury's face will be exactly where that box was. So, once you've got it to zero, up here will be the offset. It'll be minus one, so it'll be pushed out that one extra, because it's got that extra pixel. So, it'll be in the exact right place. And, if we go back to that. For player two, it'll be 272. So, this second option will be minus 272. So this will get pushed up 272 pixels, so it will show the second box which says player 2. So as you can see, when you're player 2, it will highlight like that. This same process has to be repeated for all the players. They all have to have a box and it has to be in the exact same place. The only difference between the boxes, obviously player 3 is going to say player 3, player 2, player 2, player 1, player 1. These boxes, as I said, will overlap each other. And here in the levels TXT, you can actually set what layer they'll be on. So the layer, obviously player 1 I've set to be on top, so player 1 will always be the front layer. This one, obviously player 2, I've changed the last number 1 digit down, so that will be shown in the layer underneath. And finally player 3 will be the bottom layer. Okay, so, I mean, these numbers, you can just copy these straight, you shouldn't have any problems with that. And once you've got your waiting animation made, obviously this, you have to do a whole animation, so I've gone for a very simple one. It's just two animation frames, so a bright animation frame and a dark one, so it's a constant flashing animation. It's just two frames. I'll actually show you the frames now. Here we have waiting one and waiting two. Now here on your waiting animation, you also have to set your offset at 0 and 0 if you're using the same templates as me, and this script right here is needed to stop a shadow going over the stage. The boxes that you've made will display a shadow on the stage if you don't do this. So at CMD space change light space as many nines as you want. You can put more in if you want, but I mean this many will do the trick. And what I've done is I've done a delay of 1, so it very quickly gets rid of the shadows on that first animation frame right there, and then I've done a delay of whatever I want the actual animation to have, just a delay of 20. So this will be constantly looping, but obviously this is the main animation right here. This first bit is just to activate that script right there to get rid of any shadows. Okay, so you can obviously copy and paste this as well. I'll try to post up all the codes and something for you to use as a template. And this is my selected animation. Obviously for selected you could just make these boxes disappear. I've decided to be a bit fancy and I've got these plain white boxes, so they will display perfectly over the character's face who you've picked. And this code right here will just fade out the white box. So that's pretty much all you need to know. The select animation right there and the waiting. It's mainly about the levels TXT, placing it in the right place and using the right template. Again, if you want to be really fancy with your animations, you can do more than two frames for the box surrounding them. This trick doesn't use any scripts. You do not need any scripts for this. But obviously, depending how many animations you put into your waiting animation, it could make your mod a bit bulkier and heavier to load the select screen. So this is how you do the trick, and all that's left, I believe, is to see it in action. And again, this is a different character using the same, almost exactly the same code, just copy and pasted. But do remember, with your boxes, all the colours you use in these boxes have to be in your character's palette. Otherwise, obviously, you'll get lots of colour issues and it won't look right. So, finally, all that's left to do is to see it in action. So, here we go. I hope this runs alright. As you can see, there's my box flashing perfectly over Kazuya's face there. press left, it goes over Asuka and Bright and Fury. I'll even add player 2 in there just to show you how it overlaps. So as you can see, player 2 is being pushed into the background and player 1's on top, and that should be just fine. So let's pick some players. Okay, when I pick Bright and Fury, you'll see that white box go straight over his face and then just fade out to give a nice little, and Asuka as well. And let's kick some ass. Yeah. Okay, that's enough fun. And there you have it.